going out to the shed. It's getting more and more grotty. You know how sheds get when you you start putting things in the door and shutting the door, and you hope that it's all sorted out for you, and then you get a bit further in and all of a sudden you find, ah, the car won't fit in there. Let's see what we can do about it. Yeah, well, here we go. Let's have a look in here. Well, I can get the red car in there all right, but I can't get the ute in. It's a real squeeze. I get a couple of inches each end. Need to make a bit of room at the back. That box there is full of blue metal. I can get rid of that. Filing cabinet's broken. Another one's broken over there. If I can't fix them, I can throw them out, but I'll see if I can fix them. And down the back, I've got fibro cement sheeting, I've got plasterboard. See if I can move that out to the sea container. Make a bit of room here at the back. A couple of hours later, let's see if the battery charge has done any good. Thank you. aboard to the sea container, but it's raining again, so that's not going to happen. Move this stuff for a while, so I guess we're going to have to watch out for snakes. Tennis table when I was about five, so it's over 65 years old. It's been used for all sorts of things since then. Once the house got smaller, it got used for shelving and all sorts. This fibro cement's as heavy as hernia board. Might just move that one first and then get the faster board next. Yeah, well, that's all cleared away. My next job will be to clean all that mess up, all the leaves and the rubbish that's been in there. Make sure there's no tiger snakes, because I've seen one out the back. And put some flashing in. I've got some flashing sitting up in the corner left over from the house. And all that fibro cement and plasterboard, I'm probably going to put that in the sea container for a while. Don't know how long it's going to sit there, but it's left over from the house and I don't like throwing it away. I might use it for another job. We'll see how we go. Yep, well, that's the last of it. Got it in the sea container. And all stacked there neatly. It's out of the way. I can put the saw back against the wall now. And this is my dirty sawdusty area, so I keep the shed nice and reasonably clean. So all the sawdust stays out here in the sea container and all the good stuff goes in the shed. So now I'll be able to get the ute in. Before I only had 6 inches front and back of the ute to park it. Now I'll be able to put the slasher further back against the back wall of the shed and I can drive the ute in when I go to Perth in the MR2.